According to Kabianga, the mistakes committed by the leaders of the Obusinga Bwarenzururu then ended into a deadly clash between security organs and the royal guards in 2016, resulting into the arrest of King Charles Wesley Mumbere and his subjects, but also leaving 55 people dead, including 14 policemen and 44 militias.
The pro-politicians, their only intention was to finish off the anti-politicians. And obviously they take over and take political leadership. And it happened.
Kabianga, who was also a leader in the Obusinga Bwarenzururu, explained that they divided themselves into three groups with contradicting intentions.
We had three groups, but unfortunately each group didn't know the intention of the other. We had a group of politicians whose participation in the kingdom was entirely politics and winning elections using the institution.
He added that the different intentions and ideologies amongst the three groups brought about confusion and betrayal.
We would all be in the vehicle of cultural identity, but with different what? Intentions. And eventually we ended up confusing the population. Totally. And I would like to apologize for that.
Kabianga, however, pledged that they will not repeat the mistakes that tarnished the reputation of the kingdom.
Probably you didn't understand. So that one is forgivable. But the second mistake is intentional. If you do the same mistake the second time, that one is intentional and it is unforgivable.
On 13th of June 2023, the Director of Public Prosecutions dropped all charges imposed on King Charles Wesley Mumbere and his 217 subjects, making him free to access his kingdom after a period of 7 years.
Join us in focusing on five issues. One, we want reconciliation. Let us reconcile one with another.
Of late, the Obusinga Bwarenzururu instituted a committee responsible for the king's home, coming as they long to have a rebranded institution set on five elements, mainly reconciliation, peace and mindset change, as explained by Dr. Nathaniel Mumbere Walemba, the chairman of the committee.
We want unity. Three, we want peace. Four, we want socio-economic transformation. And five, mindset change. We said anyone who will not be doing things in line with these things is not wishing us well.
According to Lieutenant Joe Walusimbi, the Resident District Commissioner, Kasese District, government is ready to accord the Obusinga Bwarenzururu protection.
The Obusinga's coming is obvious that we have to take care of him, as the government have been taking care of him even before these cases were told.
The Obusinga Bwarenzururu is currently in a campaign of soliciting funds worth 9 billion shillings from the royal subjects and well-wishers to cater for the Omusinga's homecoming, purchase of a business house and forthcoming anniversary coronation, all slated to take place in October 2023. Story compiled by Samuel Amanyide for the news.